in the Lord and in the strength of his power. Let me emphasize again, his power. Not your neighbor's power, not your mama's power, not your daddy's power, not even your power, but by the power of the Holy Spirit, the dunamis power, the third person of the Trinity, God's power, the power from the beginning of time said, let there be light, and there was light. That power that said, let there be humankind, and there was humankind. The kind of power that make the sun rise and the stars to be in the sky. The kind of power that will split the Red Sea. The kind of power in the New Testament that will turn water into wine. The wine turns into a good tasting flavor. The kind of power that will make a lame man a leaping man, a blind man a seeing man. Am I talking to somebody right now? The same power that told Lazarus to get up from the grave. That's the power that God is asking us to take up through the words of the Apostle Paul. Here is our instructions, church, that as you take up the armor of God, finally, don't you forget to take up the power of God. Take up the power. Somebody say, take up the power. This is why he speaks this to us. Why? Because Paul understood. He understood resistance feeds fear. Resistance feeds fear. Matter of fact, I experience resistance as fear. You will experience resistance in your life as fear. Think of all the many visions and dreams and missions and ideals and compassionate heart desires of God that you wanted to do that you never did. What stopped it? What hindered it? What quenched its energy to fulfill your vision and your mission? What was it that hindered you from believing that you could do all things through Christ but fail? What was it? You can say all the words you want, but at the end of the day, the bookmark would say fear. It was fear that hindered you. It was fear that resisted you from living clean your blessed life. I'm not going to let fear hinder me from living my blessed life. Somebody say, I ain't going to let it happen. Resistance as fear, but lean in. What is fear? Fear of what? What are you fearful of? What is this thing called fear? I'm glad you asked, Calvin. Fear of the consequences of following your heart. Fear. You know, you want to do great things. Your heart has motivated you to do great things, but fear will put in the fear of the consequences of walking and living in your greatness. You can't be fearful of the consequences. You got to believe that God can do it. You can't be fearful of bankruptcy, fearful of poverty, fear of insolvency, fear of being selfish, fear of failing, fear of failure, and fear of being ridiculous. I like that. You can't be fearful of being ridiculous. I don't care what people say. If God's giving it to you, don't you be afraid. Don't you be fearful. Even if it sounds ridiculous. When Noah was told by God to build the ark, it sounded ridiculous. But he built it anyway. Don't you be fearful. Don't be fearful of launching into the void, of hurtling too far out there, fear of passing some point of no return. Don't be fearful, beyond which cannot be recanted, cannot be reversed, cannot be rescinded. Don't be fearful if you can't recant it, if you can't reverse it, if you can't rescind it. Don't be fearful of that. But live with the choice that you made. Live with that choice for the rest of your life. Don't be afraid of it. Don't let it resist you. Because at the end of the day, at least you can say, I tried. I tried to live my blessed life. I tried to believe in every word that God called me to believe in. I tried, Lord. I didn't let resistance hinder me from living as a faithful woman or man of God. I didn't let Satan take my joy. I tried. Lord, we tried. See, church, all that I just stated, they are some serious forms of fear. But, somebody say but. But they are not the real fear. They are not the real fear. Write that down. Bankruptcy, insolvency, having a big idea, consequences, those are not real fear. Those are just symptoms of the bigger one. Oh, I'm coming down your alley. No, those fears, matter of fact, are not the fears. They're not the master fear. They are not even the mother of all fears. Let me hear this to you, or say this to you. Not the master fear, the mother of fears. That's not them. But it's so close to you that even when you verbalize it, you won't even believe it. This real fear is so close to you that you won't even verbalize it, and when you hear it, you won't believe it. Here is the real fear, wrapped in three parts of who we are. First, the fear of succeeding. Oh, I just knocked somebody out. The fear of succeeding. I told you the symptoms of it. All those I just spoke to you, but resistance will use you being fearful of being successful. Oh, that was something powerful right there. Fear will get in your spirit, and you will get to a place where you will fear that you will succeed. Did you hear that? So many people have not stepped out and believed that they can do all things because they were fearful of the success. They're comfortable just getting by. Fear that they will succeed. is knowing that we can access the power we secretly know we possess. Oh, I'm going to say it again. I'm feeling good here. Let me not sweat this out. See, when you know that you have the power to be successful, you are acknowledging that you have access to this power. And it's deep within you. And we push it down and resist it, because with this power of knowing that we can be successful with Christ and overcome all things but fail, means it comes with a responsibility. Oh, there it is. And believing in the power. Did you hear that? Fear gets in the way, though, and fear that we can become the person we sense in our hearts we truly are and will become by the power of the Holy Spirit. We get fearful, and we will resist it. Even church folks who's been going to church all their lives, they can shout amen and clap their hands. But when it comes to truly being successful in the Word of God, they get fearful to actually access the power that even Apostle Paul says, take hold of, because it belongs to you. Because of the responsibility as being a disciple of Jesus Christ. We like living just enough for the city. We don't want to take hold of the responsibility. This is why this is the most terrifying prospect. Watch this. This is the most terrifying prospect of the America history. Being foretold once again in the streets of America we now live in today. Can I just get a little activist right now? Because of this fear that we see running rampant on our streets, police brutality, inequality, it's because it injects that if everyone knows that all of humanity is made in the image of God, fearfully and wonderfully made, capable to be successful people of God, regardless of the color of our skin, fear and resistance will be destroyed. But fear runs rapidly through our community. Putting fear in the super powerful, in those who believe their skin color is superior over others, that they are fearful of seeing a people of color rise up. And so they push them down out of fear. And then we of color will even receive that and stay in our place out of fear of what may happen to us. But I come to tell somebody today that this is the day that God is calling God's people to stand up and resist the powers that be and call on the name of Jesus to pour down on us. And don't be afraid to be successful. With God, all things are but for them to be possible, we have to be successful. Tear down whatever forms of racism that's in this world. Inequality and equity that we see. It's time for us to stand up and be successful believers of Jesus Christ. When we believe in who he is, fear can be destroyed. Resistance can be pushed away. When the church becomes the church that God called it to be, there's nothing that can hinder us or stop us from being all that he's called us to be. Not even the gates of hell shall prevail, because we now have this power to succeed. But fear says no. Fear every day comes to stop our blessings. Fear comes every day to resist us. Fear says no. Fear will resist and will kill. I said, fear will resist and fear will kill whatever looks successful. Oh, I just told somebody amen right there. Fear will kill it if it looks like it's going to be successful. Individually and collectively, if it looks like you're going to be successful, fear's going to show up. If it looks like you're about to be a successful doctor, a successful lawyer, a successful husband, a successful wife, a successful person of this community, fear will show up to resist you being successful. Fear will resist progress for all of God's children. Fear does not like progress. Fear does not see us uniting. Rather, it wants us to stay divided. Fear wants to keep a division among us. But we have to be successful in believing that we can overcome this fear. Fear will even resist equity, equality. Fear will lie to you and tell you that folks are trying to destroy the police department when we're saying let's refund how we use the money in our community, that we can reform our prison system and our judicial system. Fear will tell you, no, no, that will destroy law and order. Fear will tell you that they're trying to take your police. Fear will have you thinking that they're going to take your suburbs away from you. Fear will have you thinking that folks coming across the wall is going to take your jobs and your house and even your people. Fear. Fear. Fear doesn't like us coming together nor progress. Fear will resist a successful ideology of regardless of the color of your skin. We all have the right to live life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. Fear will say, no, no, keep that ideal away. This fear of success can even be detrimental to our own personal success. We will sabotage our own success, church, and resist being great because of the responsibility of being successful. Churches have failed because they were fearful of a successful vision. Churches have relinquished their power and their authority because they didn't believe in the success of the church. It failed and died. Fear will have you give up your power to allow someone else to lord over you. Oh, I just told somebody right there, you better get your paper ready. Fear will tell you you're not strong enough. You can't be successful. You can't even read a sentence. You can't talk. You don't look right. You ain't the right skin color. Matter of fact, your gender is not even correct. You a female. You can't be the vice president of the United States. You can't be that. Fear will come and tell you that you need to sit down and let those who know what they're doing to do it. And we have relinquished the very power that we have to be successful people out of fear of believing if we did it, we fail, and we allow others to watch this lean in, Lord over us. And who is this Lord over us? The government, the system, the man. You've all said it. You know, I'm just going to let them take care of it. This fear will have us say ignorant stuff like, I'm not going to vote. My vote don't count. That's a person fearful of being successful. You want to change what you see in America? You want to change the ideology of America? You want to see a better community, a better world? Well, you need to get up first and make a change happen and be a successful person who will vote. I don't care what your party is, but at least let your power be known by pushing the button. Don't let nothing hinder you. Don't let nobody make you afraid or fearful of voting. I don't care what they say about the post office. I don't care about what they say at the polls. You need to go and vote. By all power necessary within you, be successful. If you can't be successful in that, you don't have the right to complain the next 4 years about nothing. All you got to do is just suck up who's lording over you because you allowed it to happen. You walked in a place of fear, and now here's the consequences. You have to stand up to this fear. I want you to hear this. Don't be so fearful that when you hear the word law and order, that you believe that law and order really means law and order. Just another word to keep you in place. That's the order that the system, the government, the man calls upon to do, to keep things the way it should be. That's called conservatism, to hold what's status quo in place. To keep you in line, to keep you field folks in line, to keep you house folks in line. And the moment we rise up and have the birth of a nation, we have now a problem. We have a problem with law and order because you're not following rules of law. You're not staying in line. But I double dog dare you to get out of your fearful mentality and stand up and speak truth to power and reclaim your victory to live a blessed life and declare resistance will not hinder us from living what God intended for us to live way back then when he said you can and shall have all things because I came not to harm you but to bless you, to give you a future with a hope. It's time you get up off your assets and give God some praise because it's time to live a blessed life. I'm gonna wait. I'm waiting. Somebody shouting. Not only are we fearful of being successful, we're also fearful of discovering. Somebody say discovering. We fear discovering that we are more than we think we are. Have you stopped discovering the best you? Have you given up trying to be the best you? Have you surrendered the adventure of living blessed? Have you given up your dreams and vision to be the best you and just decided to live just enough?
we fear this ideal of discovery more than what people think we are. We're more fearful of discovering who we are than what people think we are. We fear that we actually possess the talent that our still small voice tells us. You know that voice speaks to you. That will actually tell you you are destined for greatness. That we actually have the guts and the perseverance, the capacity to discover that we can do all things through Christ who gives us the strength and power. Listen to me, church. Who told you you couldn't? When Adam and Eve were in the garden, God said, all of this is yours. Follow my instructions, and you shall live a blessed life. The only instructions I really give to you is don't eat from this tree. And God says, but the rest of all this is yours. And he gives them some space, and they enjoy the blessed life. But in the midst of living the blessed life, here comes resistance. Here comes fear. Here comes Satan speaking to the people. And he says, you can eat from that tree. God ain't gonna hurt you. Go ahead and eat from it. And they ate, fell into sin, and God comes back and said, Adam, where are you? He said he was hiding. And when he came out, he said, why are you hiding? And Adam said, that snake told me. That snake told me. What am I trying to say within the story of that story? Listen to me. Lean in. So often it's fear and resistance that tell us not to believe in who God is. It's that snake that tells us that we can do wrong and get away with it. But God is saying, who told you? Listen to me. He said, who told you you was naked? He said, no. I don't care if you are my child. Who told you that lie? Lean in. Did y'all hear that? Who told you that lie? I don't care if you're naked. Don't you ever be ashamed. You can be naked and unashamed. Believe in yourself. Discover who I created you to be. Who told you you couldn't go to college? Who told you couldn't start a business? Who told you couldn't be a good man? Who told you couldn't be a good woman? Who told you couldn't be full of self-esteem? Who told you couldn't break out of poverty? Who told you that it was okay to just get by living paycheck to paycheck? Who told you when God has given you the power and the authority to discover that you can live your blessed life? Go and do likewise. Don't be afraid to discover who you are. Step out and see what the end is going to be. I double dog dare somebody today to listen to that voice within them. Push the resistance away and listen to God speak to you in such a way that you discover that you can do all things through Christ. You discover that God, who begun a good work in you, shall bring it to completion. Don't you stop going to school. Don't you throw in the towel. Don't you give up. Keep your hand to the plow. Don't you look back, but keep your eyes to the hills, which cometh your help. Your help comes from the Lord. That's where your strength comes. That's where your power comes from. When you discover who you are, you discover that you can do it. Can't nothing stop you. Can't nothing hinder you. Not even fear itself. Touch your neighbor and say, it's time to discover. Fear of what? Fear of succeeding. Fear of discovering. And lastly, fear of faith. I said, fear of faith. I've discovered, church, that many churches, many disciples who sits in pews, who raise their hands and say they believe in Jesus Christ, have missed living blessed lives because they are fearful to walk by faith. They shout every Sunday. You know, they shout. They rock. They grab the Holy Spirit. They shake. They give the ugly face. They lean back and forth. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. They'll tell the pastor, that was a good word. The choir sung, Calvin. Our church was wonderful. But soon as they step out the door and begin to truly live out what God's called them to live out, fear steps in and says, hey, church is over now. You had good faith in the building. Put that stuff down. And when life really happens, instead of believing in the word of God, instead of knowing that this is the power to give you strength, it's power to tear down strongholds, it's power to heal a sin-sick soul, we run to the place called I don't know, and believing in fear and doubt. When you just left believing in the church, the faith of Jesus, we'll even have fear in church. Oh, you're like, no, I don't. Let me just talk about money. We'll find out how much faith you got. We'll find out who's running your life, faith or fear. Just to tithe, just to give an offering. You look at your money and look over at God. Look at your money, look over at God. And when it's time to give, do you give out of looking at your money or do you give looking out at God? When you give out looking at your money, you're giving out of fear. But I come to tell somebody, it's time to give looking toward the hills, looking to God, walking by faith and not by sight. Lord, I don't care what I see, but I believe in who you are, that if you are the Almighty, you're going to make a way out of no way. So take what I have out of faith and make a way. Somebody ought to be shouting, because in the midst of this pandemic, you shouldn't have what you have right now, but you have more than enough. Don't say it was because of who you or what you've done. It's because of the grace and the mercy of God that even in the midst of a pandemic, your lights is still on. Your mortgage is still paid. Your clothes is still on your back. Food still on your table. Matter of fact, you ain't dead with the 180,000, but you woke up this damn morning. You ought to give God some praise that it was his faith. We let fear run us. That we say we are disciples. But are you truly walking by faith? In a real sense, out of fear of faith, we want to steer our own ship. We want to plant our own flag and reach our own promised land. We want to do it in the physical and not by faith. We fear faith. I'm talking to the church. Because I know Delrose could be even greater a church. But fear has resisted the faithfulness of his people. We can and shall be a blessed people when we get over trying to do it ourselves. We have to overcome this fear of faith because it's with our faith. Somebody say my faith. Can I just tell my story? It's with my faith. Spiritually, I have become estranged from all I know physically. The more I walk in my faith, the more spiritual I get, and the more physical restraints of this world I'm not afraid of. I can and shall do all that God puts in my heart to be the hands and feet of Jesus Christ. I will not let physical limitations hinder me from my spiritual blessings. I shall walk by faith all the days of my life. It may be ridiculous. You may talk about me. But at the end of the day, even the skeptics will say to me, that was a man who walked by faith. He started businesses. He was a true entrepreneur spiritually and physically. He trusted that God can open up the windows of heaven and pour down blessings because he was not afraid to walk in his faith. He was not afraid to discover. He was not afraid to be successful. Church, when you're not afraid to live your blessed life, not even the gates of hell, Satan can't stop it. Only you can let the fear within you devour the faith that's in you. Which one are you going to live by today? Are you going to live by fear, which is physical? Are you going to live by faith, which is spiritual? Faith operates in the spiritual realm. Fear operates on the physical realm. But they both operate the same way. Did you hear me? They both are things that are unseen. You remember faith? Faith is the substance of the things unseen, of future hope for. Fear operates the same thing. Fear are the things you're afraid of that will come into your life. And so you either let fear move you into your future. Oh, somebody hear me. Are you going to let faith move you into your future? Which one are you living into? Are you living in the physical? Are you living in the spiritual? Are you living in a place where you say, my physical limitations won't allow me to be the best me? Are you going to live in the spirit? Well, regardless that if you're in a chair, or you can't walk or can't talk. Helen Keller couldn't see, hear, or talk, but we know her name. Why? Because she walked and lived out of her faith. She believed that even if she couldn't see, touch, or talk, she still can do all things. Come on, somebody. You can see every day, touch every day, talk every day, and still won't walk by faith. Still won't live in the spirit. When we walk by faith and not by sight, watch this. Those who are having trouble with faith, when we walk by faith and not by sight, we pass through a membrane. Somebody say membrane. Membrane is that place or boundary where you move from one metabolism into another, where you move from being in a physical place to a new place. That new place is a spiritual, is a realm where you move from living in that first degree to the third degree living. We become, watch this, lean in. You become living faith walkers. You wake up every day walking in faith, and you're no longer walking or being the walking living dead. So are you living faith walkers, or are you the walking dead? You know, you're just walking around, but you're dead inside. You wake up every day dead. You talking dead. You know how you talk dead. I can't, I won't, I never be. I don't know why we trying this now. I can't do it. I just don't understand. This is what I'm supposed, that's walking dead. You just walk around with a dead spirit. I don't want to live that kind of life where I wake up every day dead. No. I want to wake up living my blessed life. I want to wake up spiritually. I want to wake up as a walking, living spirit of God. I want to wake up and look and say, this is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. I want to wake up every day and say, there is a possibility that God is going to show up. And when he shows up, he's going to show out. And when he shows out, I'm going to praise him for making a way. Anybody tired of living and walking dead? It's time to wake up. Touch your neighbor and say, it's time to wake up. When we embrace our faith, we prove the worthiness of our faith. And that scares the hell even out of the devil. When you wake up and start walking in your faith, and resisting the fear of walking in faith, even the devil becomes fearful. That was a shout right there. You want the devil to run from you? Get some faith. When the devil sees that you are a faithful person, it won't even mess with you. You gotta cover yourself. Pour the Spirit of God in you and believe that when you begin a good race, don't you quit. Don't you give up. Stay in the race. When we resist fear and live by faith, we will lose some friends and family members who will no longer recognize us. But here's the trick. You will discover that the I am is with you. You'll discover that Emmanuel will never leave you. When you begin to walk in faith, when you discover who you are and not be afraid of being a successful disciple of Jesus Christ, you may lose some folks who don't recognize this new you, but God will keep you. Emmanuel will be with you. He says, I'll never leave you nor resist you. I'll give you the power to do all things. God will even give you unquenchable, undepletable, inexhaustible source of power, wisdom, and knowledge to understand, to stand against the world and proclaim. Nothing can stop you nor resist you from living a blessed life. Nothing can stop you. You have to have a spirit to believe that when you put your hands to the plow and know that you can succeed. Yes, know that you can discover a new you and walk by faith. Nothing can stop you. You have the power and the authority. Go get your blessing. Go get your blessing. Don't let nothing stop you. there's a movie clip that I want you to see. Media team, show what I'm talking about.
Vincent. My God, you have changed. Has it been so long you don't recognize your own brother?
Are we brothers?
Our parents both died thinking they'd outlived you. I had my doubts.
What are you doing here, Anton?
I should ask you that question. I have a right to be here.
You don't. You almost sound as if you believe that. I committed no murder. You must be disappointed.
You committed fraud. Listen, you're in a lot of trouble, Benson. I can get you out of here.
Do you have any idea what it took to get in here?
You've gone as far as you can go. You come with me now.
There are still a few million miles left to go.
It's over.
Is that the only way you can succeed, is to see me fail?
I'm telling you.
God, even you are gonna tell me what I can and can't do now. In case you haven't noticed, I don't need any rescuing. But you did once. Well, you've got all the answers. How do you explain that?
You didn't beat me that day. I beat myself.
Who are you trying to convince?
You want me to prove it to you?
It's not important, Anton. It's forgotten.
I'll prove it to you. You want me to prove it to you? I'll prove it to you!
I do.
What are you doing, Miss Vincent? Have you done any of this? We have to go back. Now it's too late for that. We're close to the other side. What other side? You want to drown us both? You want to know how I did it? This is how I did it, Anton. I never saved anything for the swim back.
Thank you.
never saved anything for the swim back. Church, Vincent, who lived in the world, who believed he couldn't do what he was doing because he wasn't born the way they were born. But Vincent believed in himself. He discovered who he was, and he had a passion to succeed. And he wouldn't let fear hinder him. His brother Antoine believed he should have been fearful because he wasn't like him. He believed he shouldn't be discovering that he could do all things. He believed he shouldn't be successful. But Vincent believed he could be successful. Vincent believed and discovered who he was. Vincent resisted and lived a blessed life and achieved his vision and his goal and his dream because he walked by faith and not by sight. He was ridiculous in believing that he never swam to go back. Never had going back in my church. You want to be successful. You want to be strong. You want to be courageous. You want to live a blessed life. It's time to get up and go. Don't you look back at your past. I don't care what you've been through. I don't care what you've done. Best is yet to come. Discover it. Believe in it. Walk in it. Be successful. Church, we're in the midst of this pandemic. I know, but we don't have to look back at it, but we can keep going forward. I know racism exists, and it's trying to destroy our community. It's good to be some kids and call for burden to remember and look back, but let's keep our eye on the prize. Don't let us get stuck in our past, but let us march on by faith, discovering the best for America, discovering that we can be successful as the body of Christ and as this country. Don't give up. The best is yet to come. I pray this sermon series touched someone's life. I tried my best by the power of God to encourage you in the midst of this pandemic, in the midst of this season of racism, that God didn't call us a living mess, but he called us to be blessed. Let us not resist that vision. This is the word of God for the people of God. If there's someone who needs prayer, please just message us on Facebook. We'll pray for you. We're praying that you will help us as a ministry. On YouTube, they said if we get subscribers to subscribe to our page, we'll be able to reach more people. So we're asking that you subscribe to our YouTube page. Not only subscribe, but we pray that you'll be able to continue to give to our ministry. Wherever you are, you can still help the ministry of our virtual worship go live across this country through Facebook, through YouTube, and through our website. It's through your giving that we have created what we have. We're still learning our technology. We're still getting the lighting system corrected. We're still getting our sound and our platforms of using videos and using music, connecting it to our worship. We thank you. please pray with us as we're still waiting for that time to come back to worship together physically. But let us not get hung up on not being together physically, but let's stay connected spiritually and through virtual worship, through Bible study virtually. We'll be back in September on Wednesdays. And I want you to know that we'll be back at the Rose Cafe, but because I've been on vacation, I've been leaving my computer at home, so I don't have it right now. So we'll be blessing you next Sunday when we're back in Saddle on the first Sunday for the Rose Cafe. So if you're looking to see me this afternoon, we won't be there, but we'll be there next Sunday. I want to thank all of you for joining us on this Sunday. Stand to your feet as we now receive this benediction and take the light back into the world. May the power of God bless you all, strengthen you, and encourage you to live your blessed life. Give all that you have in whatever God has placed within your heart. Take nothing for your journey. Don't look back. Keep your eyes to the hills, which cometh your help. Don't let the fear of succeeding hinder you, the fear of discovering and the fear of walking in faith stop you. Walk in God's power, walk in God's love, walk in God's strength. You are God's child, and if he promised it, you can do it. Greater works you shall do. Go now and win the war of living blessed. Go and be blessed, people. Let your light shine. May the power of God rest, rule, and abide within all of your hearts and your homes from this day and forevermore. And all of God's children said, amen. Remember, I love you. I mean, I really love you. Jesus loves you. And there ain't nothing you can do about it. God bless you. See you next Sunday. Have a good one.